of course, a lot of the talk beforehand was a lot about how potentially weird it would be to see photorealistic animals singing and talking in the film. But I truly believe that both Flounder and Sebastian work great in this film. But still, for you guys to see this film, to see on the big screen real life-like animals speaking and singing your voices, doesn't that feel just a little weird?
Oh, it certainly does. Especially at the start of watching it. I mean, it's always weird to hear your own voice in anything, yeah. Let alone on a fish or a crab's face, but
why don't you kiss the girl?
No, I was very young when I did it, so for me personally, I was like, I couldn't really recognize my own voice, if that made sense.
You gotta show him who's in charge!
Yeah, but yeah, I know exactly what you mean. It totally, yeah.
Yeah, it's weird to hear your own voice anyway. You're right. Like, even if you listen to yourself talk, it's a weird experience. But I agree with you. Like, it didn't seem like it should work. And then as soon as they did such a good job with building the world that, like, it's such a specific look, you know, like everything is intentional. And mm-hmm. as soon as they started talking, I was like, yeah, I get it.
The human world is a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got going on up there.
I was a little disturbed by how much I think Sebastian looks like me.
The amazing thing is also, of course, you both have experience in voicing animals before. I mean, Jacob, you were Pete the cat, and David, yeah. of course, you've been a fox on BoJack Horseman. You've yeah. been a hedgehog in Ferdinand.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, that's right.
You've been
yeah.
a rat king. So, yeah. I mean, do you guys, like, are you so accustomed to voicing animals that you find yourself doing it involuntarily when you meet animals in real life?
Definitely.
Doesn't everybody do that, though? Like, do you have pet? Anyone who has a dog, like, has a voice for their dog, right?
Yeah.
Like, because you have to talk to them, and they have to talk back.
And they have to talk back.
Yeah, I feel like I feel like people do that. We're constantly making up voices for animals.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, I got a pet bunny, Benny, yeah. mm-hmm. of course, which is a real, you know, it's a weird animal because it just doesn't make any noise at all. So I do have to make all the voices, all the words that he does.
That's what I'm saying. Like, Benny for sure has a voice in your head, whether you ever do it out loud or not, like that.
David, I also wanted to ask you, because, of course, you worked with Lin-Manuel Miranda before, of course, on Hamilton.
Mm-hmm.
And I read an interview with him where he said specifically that he couldn't get himself to write any new song material for Sebastian because those original songs were just too perfect
yeah.
for him. And I just wanted to ask you, you yourself, you're an experienced singer, experienced songwriter. Do you hold the same sort of reverence for this character in songs like, you know, Under the Sea and Kiss the Girl?
Go on and kiss the girl.
Yeah, I mean, lyrically, those songs are shockingly good. It's really, yeah, if you're anyone who's a writer, if you really sit and listen to those lyrics and how they, not only like the meanings of them and all the crazy wordplay in there, but also like rhythmically, they're perfect. They are really incredibly impressive songs.
Yeah, no, you could like listen to these songs like over and over and over again, especially the visuals too, and you know, it would never get old. I mean, they're just timeless, yeah.
Yeah, when I went in to audition for this, I hadn't seen the film or listened to the music in at least, probably 15 years at least, you know? And I went in and had 5 minutes with the accompanist before we started, and he started running the songs, and I immediately still knew all the words, and like knew all the melodies, knew exactly what the songs did. Like, that's how good those songs are, that even after 15 years of not listening to them, I still knew them.
I wanna be where the people are. I wanna see them dancing, walking around on those, what do you call them? Oh, feet.
I actually got the opportunity to hear her sing in person. It was cool because it was literally just a rehearsal and she wasn't even trying and still like hit every note perfectly. It was amazing, and then obviously she's just such a kind person. And then to see her performance in this film all finished with the finalized CGI and everything, yeah, she just does a phenomenal job and she's a great person.
Yeah, she's the one. I don't know, nobody else could play this role. It's all her.
Part of that world.